absolute sick. We're gonna kick some butt.
Bobby!
Very bad. He's sick and he just came to weigh in, but he's not yet.
George Langevin Productions presents today at El Cajon Valley High School, we have the Kearney Mesa Comets against the El Cajon Braves. Hi, everybody. Should be a good football game as we get ready to go. We've got kickoff about to start as the captains meeting each other once more. The traditional handshake before the start of the game. We'll look at some of the captains for El Cajon. We have Maxwell, number 38, as well as Travis House, number 72, and the kickoff right away. Receiving in El Cajon as they get it outside. They're on the 10-yard line. And tackled right away by Kearney Mesa. We don't have a good spotting public address announcer today. It's going to be very difficult to try to be completely right on the money with identifying some of these plays. We'll do the best we possibly can for you. We really will. And try to give you as much call as we can. Back to throw quarterback for the Braves. He gets back to throw and he can handle it. A sack by number 54, Steve Williamson, as he nails Eric Patton, the quarterback. Let's go down the offense if we can for El Cajon. We have Frank Clark, Eric Patton, Ethan Banegas, Aaron Sanders. As we get into the next playoff right away, we got a second down play. Up the middle, number 34, the running back, DJ Anderson. DJ with a gain of about 5 or 6 yards, very close to the first down. It's going to be third and short at the ultimate worst here. And we also have Bobby Osley running back, Sean Flowers, the tight end, Jake Wastad, Tommy Allison, Casey Spatz, Brandon Osberg, Pat Healy, Darren Hamilton, the center today, Rocky Seamers, the offensive tackle, Toby Greider, the tight end, and Jordan Beal, the split end. We'll get the defense for Kearney in a second. And a pass that flipped away, intercepted. Intercepted by Kearney. Now he drops the football. And now he's upset. Apparently the referee called the play dead before it happened. Let's see what the call is going to be. I believe that was number 82 for the defense for Kearney. Chris White with his hand on the ball. Either him or Marvin Lennon, number 83. One of those two in the action there. Referees were talking it over. And as they do, let's get the defense mentioned for Kearney Mesa. We have Ike Okenwa, Jason Gardner, Kevin McCaffrey, number 45, Isaiah Schisler, the coach's son, Stephen Williamson, Raul Marquez, Brian Lovell. And now that goes against El Cajon, and I guess they're going to call from the spot of the infraction, which is about where the ball had been resting. And apparently that play was good, but it was just called a dead play. We got the rest of the defense here for Kearney, Mean Willie Green, Sam Hollywood High. These guys must really be pretty tough cookies in the defense for them. Chris White, number 82, the defensive tackle. And we've got Marvin Bubba Lennett, the strong safety. And then Jason Groves, the nose tackle for the Kearney Mesa Comets. And now they say offensive pass interference against the El Cajon Braves. And the coach not happy with the call. And so the Braves, well, we see themselves going back towards the way back, actually, around the 10 or 15 yard line. And here we go. And they're going to kick it. A fourth down. Kick is blocked. Kick is blocked by Kearney. Oh, they got great field position. And they're about ready to maybe get one in there. I think it was Chris White, the defensive tackle, who came in and blocked that kick, if I'm not mistaken. We're just underway here in the first quarter, the Braves and the Comets. And Kearney with some great field position. Quarterbacking is Jason Valletta. And a double reverse, and a triple reverse, and they go all around. Number 10, Allie Ross. Allie going to the right-hand side, all by himself in for the score. And a touchdown, and the Kearney Mesa Comets are off to the early 6-0 lead. Nice triple reverse. They had El Cajon over along the left-hand side, veering that way, and they fooled him completely. There was nobody even near Allie as he just strolled in on his own within 5 or 10 yards of the nearest defender. And the Comets are on the board early in the first quarter. We will go over the offense for them in a second when we can, but they really Only took one play to get one in, but of course with the turnover, the block punt by the Comets, resulting in that early score. And see if they can now try to convert for the extra point. Junior Pee-wee action today at El Cajon Valley High School. Going towards the outside, trying to sweep through is Kearney, and it's good. He gets in the end zone, Chris Williams, the running back, and the Comets are leading at 7-0. So Kearney, off to a good start here on this warm Saturday afternoon. And now we get set for the kickoff. Getting some shots right now at field level. And I hope you're enjoying them. Good chance to get some good close-ups of your boys playing football. Running it down there is number 40 for El Cajon, Brian Lloyd. Lloyd drifting out past the 20-yard line, over to the 30, the 35, and the 40. To the close to the midfield line. Nice run. Tackled by Ali Ross and a couple other Comets helping out. And so the Braves are in pretty good field position to start their series of downs here in the first quarter. Kearney Mesa 7 and El Cajon nothing. Well, the Braves are very confident before the start of the game, believing that they could win. Their record on the year is 4-3. And they do want to get a win to guarantee themselves a playoff berth, so this is a big game for them as far as that goes. Now a handoff and running down there, number 15, and big runner, Frank Clark. Frank getting by, he's defender. Andrew Hogan, number 66 now, making the stop on defense. Actually, no, that was Hollywood making the tackle, but a nice run by Frank. He gets a first down for the Braves on their first downs of the game. So both teams looking sharp offensively early on. Actually, under their second series, they had that first series that was converted by Kearney, El Cajon did, and they converted it into the TD. And now an offsides against the Comets. And it's a first down for El Cajon. As they trail at 7-0. A lot of quick action here in this game early on. Hand it off to their breadwinner, yes indeed. DJ Anderson, DJ looking very strong on running back. They got a good running attack, it looks like, with Frank Clark and DJ Anderson together, the two looking pretty tough out there. As the offense tries to come back and not get down about that mistake with the block kick and also the interference call that went against them that made them lose a down. Ball rusting it around, oh, I say close to the 15-yard line. Well, we all try to spot the ball the best we can here. 7-0 to score. Pop Warner football, and we'll be back. .6:34 to go in this game, just underway. First period, El Cajon Valley Stadium. You get a good look at the marquee and the logo, the Braves logo. As we're back to action. And here comes the Braves with Frank Clark with some blocking in front there. Over along there you see Brandon Osberg, the guard, helping out, as well as Ethan Benejas, the other guard. Big part in this game to help the runners along. And this one going right near the goal line, and let's see if he gets in. Not quite, as DJ Anderson getting too close to the 1 yard line on that carry. So we've got, I believe, a third and goal coming up here for the Braves. Want to try to give you some credit to Kearney's defense, if we can too, as to who's making the tackles here. And we'll try to do so as often as be possible in this game. Of course, everybody working hard and trying to play their best game that they can. And this being week number 8 of the Pop Warner football season. Towards the outside now, run down. Kearney tackles him, but I believe he's over the goal line. Let's see. And he is, and it is a touchdown. In the action around there was Brian Lovell, the linebacker, but it didn't matter. A touchdown it is for El Cajon, and the game is not an even, it's 7. So the Comets striked first, and the Braves have striked back. And we have a 7-6 game, Kearney up by 1 point. And see if El Cajon can match that. And see if they'll give the ball back to DJ. And he'll pass it, and that one tipped nicely by the defender. Good defense by the Kearney Comets. He had his hands up high in the air, and I'm trying to see if I can identify that gentleman who did it. Couldn't quite do it, but he did it in a nice play. Made a nice play, and the Comets are still holding on to a 7-6 lead. Kickoff by the Braves, not a long one at all, close to midfield. Run down by number 83, Marvin Bubba Lennett. Lennett, that is. He plays strong safety on defense. Let's go and quickly mention the offense for the Kearney Comets. We have Max Raffet, the wide receiver, Ellie Ross, the running back, Jason Valletta, quarterbacking, Marcus Williams and Chris Williams, Nemesio Baker, the wide receiver, Mike High, the center, Andrew Hogan is the guard, Ricky Barker, the other guard, and we have Marcus Leisure, the tackle, Adam Schoolcraft, the guard, Doug Arthur, the tackle, Victor Bertagna, the guard, and then we have Todd Parker, the Nisman, running up towards the middle, taken back to Allie Ross, the running back. Allie scoring the first touchdown of the game for both sides as he got the call on the first play of the day for Kearney. And that brought him off to that quick 7-0 lead. And running out the offense, we also did mention Todd Parker, the tight end. Well, I hope you're enjoying watching this game wherever you are. We do try to be equal and bipartisan on these videotapes. We don't want to favor one team or the other. We want to call a fair game and also watch the game being played fairly as far as the referees' calls and the players themselves, the way they're behaving and their sportsmanship. And it looks good so far. This one's short, pass intended, thrown by quarterback Valletta, trying to find his man open. He couldn't do it. That was Todd Parker, and incomplete. So the ball resting at about the 45-yard line for Kearney. Here in the first quarter of action at El Cajon Valley High School. George Langevin's with you. I hope you're enjoying it. You know, if you have any other events going on during the season that you might want to get involved with, give me a call at 566-9035. I'll be very happy to set something up with you as Kearney Comets get set and get ready to go again. And I'll fumble with a football and see if El Cajon is able to recover that. That was right near them. Kearney, number 10, fumbling the football. That's Allie Ross, but I believe he recovered it. And they escape any further danger as they took advantage of the Braves turnover to get that first TD. Braves looking to even the score in that regard. So at the 45-yard lines, we're at rest. You get a small glimpse of the gallery along the left side of for Kearney on the road side of El Cajon Stadium. And the punt. A short kick right over to the receiver, Brian Lord, return man. Nice tackle by number 85, Victor Bertanga, as he nails Brian immediately. And the Braves will take over first and 10. 7-6 to score. Kearney over El Cajon. Now a quick play and taken away by Kearney as they tackle him immediately. Referees now marking the ball at about the, I believe it's around the 35-yard line there. And let's see, they spotted at the 40. So the ball is at the 40-yard line. A second down play for the Braves. And no gain on the play as Frankie got stopped. And Brian Lovell, number 56, making the tackle on Frankie. Eric Batten, the quarterback for the Braves. Handing it off right away, though, the defense reading it all the way. Tackle made on the play by number 65, Sam Hollywood High, as he's able to stop Bobby Osley. Kearney's had a tough year this year, but I was told that their schedule is a lot more difficult this year. They had a pretty good season last year, and what they do is they match you up with the better teams from the year before, and a lot of these teams stayed strong. They played Los Toros the beginning of the year. They lost 35-0. They lost to IB 13-0. But, well, they showed signs of progress as they went along and got things going. Braves with an up and down season themselves. Pass flipped over to the middle and taken by Toby Grider, and Toby making a nice catch on that. But I believe he's short of the first down they are, and Eric a little frustrated, the quarterback, because they didn't quite reach it. Now, we mentioned again, Kearney losing to Ivy and Los Toros the first 2 weeks of the year, then South Bay beat them 41-13, and they got some offense going, but it's been a slow process for them. They've really had to try to patch things together. They had some injuries early in the year. That's really slowed them down. Their quarterback going down the first week of the year, and we're going to pass it now, a fake punt. And that one is incomplete. I'm sorry, correction. That last play by El Cajon was a fourth down play, and they had been going for the first down. They were short, a little upset by it, and now Kearney on the first down play, make an incomplete pass. So a second down and 10 coming up for the Comets as they lead 7-6 in the first quarter. Shotgun, a high snap. He manages to get it off. Nice pass. Oh, off the fingertips of number 34. And Nemesio Baker, actually, he had a beat on that ball. Maybe he might have lost it in the sun. I don't know if the sun was in his eyes or not, but it tipped off his fingertips and went astray. So two consecutive passes thrown by quarterback Valletta to no avail. So we have a third down coming up. Shot there at number 81, Todd Parker, the tight end. You take a look at him in your screen. Well, I hope all the fans here are really enjoying the football game. It should be a lot of fun today. Real enthusiastic and looking real excited about being here. Down the middle as he tries to get a few yards back, but the lane really clogged up quite a bit as Allie Ross was stopped by the defense of El Cajon with number 76 in your screen there. That being Gabe Swan. Now, we really didn't mention much about the defense for the Braves, that we want to do that right now. We have Cody Fox, the cornerback, Brad Martlett, the cornerback, and Lee Pelfrey playing the same position as well. We have Justin Phelan, Max Maxwell, Brian Lloyd, Mike Martin, the outside linebacker, Lewis Scotty, the defensive end, Jacob Balsley, the nose tackle, and Chris Chaplin, the free safety, as well as Travis House, Gabe Swan, Tyler Crane, Daniel Crabtree, Nick Forsten, the tackle to round off the defense for the Braves. Play from scrimmage. They're going to go for it. Number 32, that is Chris Williams, trying for the first down. He's very close on a fourth down play, and he falls short. So El Cajon's defense holds and does the job as they stop him, and he will take over. So both sides in two consecutive series trying to get the fourth down play on a run. Actually, just a matter of just trying to get the fourth down play and get a first down, since they were not way away from the end zone, but they couldn't quite do it. Ball very close to midfield, but that is the end of the first quarter. With the score, the Kearney Mesa Comets 7 and the El Cajon Braves 6. We'll be back with the second quarter in just a moment. Here we go, we're back to action. Second quarter of play. Braves, now we'll move offensively to our right and to our left, of course, Kearney. Here we go, first and 10, nice carry, first down and more. He's all on himself now. And can he get him? And he gets him at the 10-yard line. Number 51, Isaiah Schisler, the last man between DJ Anderson and the end zone. And DJ making a great run. El Cajon has a good running attack, don't they? They've got Frank Clark and DJ Anderson, two strong running backs, and both have looked good so far today. Something Kearney's got to contend with and got to worry about throughout this football game. So a first and 10 it is, and he gets another 4 or 5 yards up to around the 5-yard line. And this time they go to Bobby Osley, the other running back. So now a flag on the play. I believe this one's going to go. to the Braves against the Comets. Let's see what their call is going to be now. And no, it will go against the Braves. As they were speaking with Kearney, and so it's, it looks as though it's either a holding penalty or a clipping call. It's holding against El Cajon. So they'll go back to all the way back around a 20-yard line. So that was a big penalty against them. See if they can make something out of that. So just into the second quarter of play. Hard to keep things going. As far as the shooting conditions today, well, it had to move us off the field and get us above, and we're trying to get settled into that spot right now. Here's El Cajon trying to make up the lost yardage and making some good progress, a good 10-yard gain back towards the 15 to the 10-yard line. We have DJ Anderson. Braves looking to take the lead for the first time today. Fake handoff, and now goes over to Frankie. And Clark gets the call for another about 5 yards. Back to about the original spot where they had it before those penalties. As they faked to DJ, and that was a good fake, and they were able to give it to Frankie. And that really helps when you have two strong runners like that. You can really be unpredictable as far as who's going to get the call. You don't know who to key on. You really can't key on anybody. And you have to worry about that quite often. And, of course, the defense doesn't really want to blitz because they know that the runners are going to be carrying the football quite often during the game. So really a good offensive situation for the Braves, who are hoping to go to the playoffs after this game is over and get going and be in the winner's bracket. Now over on his own, and he breaks the tackle. And I think he's short of the goal line. Yeah, he is. Nice try. As Anderson just short of the goal line, Kearney trying to nail him, but they couldn't quite get him as he got kicked over to the side there on the left. Coming into the game for the Braves is Jordan Beal, the split end number 88. And you hear the cheerleaders cheering on El Cajon. Here comes the call. It goes over to DJ Anderson. And a touchdown for the Braves. El Cajon taking the lead for the first time today. And he gets congratulated by his teammate, Jordan, as well as Eric Patton and Frankie Clark. And the Braves, with some good runners, take the lead for the first time. So it's now 12-7. El Cajon going out of the game quickly was number 30. That was Justin Phelan, the outside linebacker, who is helping out in that particular down. So we'll see what the Braves are gonna go for. I guess he still don't kick extra points in junior Pee. We don't know. I haven't seen anybody do it yet. I thought you were allowed to in this level of football. Now running hard is Clark. He can't get in the end zone, and the Kearney Comets with a good goal line stand to prevent the extra point tackle on the play by number 54, Steve Williamson, doing a job on the Braves for their extra point. So they lead by 5, the first time they've led in this entire football game. Pop Warner football here at El Cajon Valley High School. And a whistle is a flag on the play. I think the ball going out of bounds, and I think they're going to move the ball back to 5 yards beyond the line of scrimmage. And let's see, I believe that's going to be the call. So the Braves will have to kick off a little bit further. And yes, indeed, the referee now moving it back to the original spot. He'll mark off 5 from there. And it'll go over to the 35-yard line where the Braves will kick it there. And that's number 25 doing the honors. The kicker, that's Lee Pelfrey. So far, the Braves behind 2 touchdown runs by DJ Anderson leading in the game 12-7. That one bobbled momentarily. by number 40, Jason Gardner. Jason getting out and around, but he gets stopped close to around the 40-yard line by the Braves. And they'll take over their first and 10 as they are ready to get going. Back to throw. And that went low to the ground. Actually, Kearney taking over. And an incomplete pass intended for Baker, number 34. So we'll let I know the connect on his last three or four attempts here. He's had the ball in the vicinity, though. He hasn't been throwing into a crowd. That's a good sign for any quarterback. You know, happens a lot of times is you have a quarterback who has a tendency to just get excited and try to push the ball, kind of force it. Although it's very common with young players to do that because they want to make things happen as much as possible, and it doesn't always work that way. Billy Joe Tolliver for the Chargers has done that on occasion, although he's starting to come around this year, so we'll have to see. Here comes Kearney Mesa. Oh, and a nice jaunt down the sideline by Ross. No one there near him now. He's just outrunning. He's got blazing speed. Right behind him there is the 44, but it's a touchdown. And the defense of Mike Martin, he just was outrun. He outran everybody. Allie's got just great speed. The guy is gifted. And let's see now. No flags at all, so that is a TD. And now Kearney's going to go for the extra point. A nice run by Allie Ross, number 10. And Kearney back in the lead. As they try to run it towards the right, and Valletta can't do it. And it is now Kearney back in front, leading it now 13-12 with 6:14 remaining in the first half. A good football game it has been. And Kearney really having a good day offensively because the highest point total they had this year so far has been the third week of the year against South Bay, where they scored 13 points. So they've equaled that, and I'm sure they're getting more before this one's all over. As they're in the lead now, the ball going up to around the 35-yard line. It goes back to the 30 now. I don't know if he threw a flag there. As Allie making the tackle, would you believe, too, after that touchdown run. As he nailed Brian Lloyd. Brian doing a lot of the special teams work on the returns. Punts and kickoffs. So the ball will be spotted at about the 33-yard line. Braves will have it. First down and 10. Each team scoring two touchdowns each. The fumble on the football, and I think the Braves have it back. Let's see what the referees call it. Looked like I saw a blue jersey land on the football. Going out of the game there is Jordan Beal again. Let's see if the Braves get the football back. I thought someone had it, but maybe Kearney did recover. And now a play from the scrimmage, and nothing doing there. So the Braves do get the football back, I believe. Let's double check again now. Didn't see the referee make any signal. Indeed, they did get the football back, so they have recovered the fumble. They have it on their own 8-yard line. Try to, again, be as accurate as I can with the markings of the football. Yes, indeed, at the 38-yard line. Braves have it. Second down play, pass, and caught. Nice play. Nice combination play there as Jordan Beal making the catch from Patton. And he'll go out of the game as he does his job when he came in, and that's the way to do it. So now we're close to a first down for the Braves. It's a little over 5 minutes remaining in the first half. Braves trailing at 13-12 to Kearney. Ball now spotted at the 35-yard line. Actually, 45-yard line. Running towards the left side now, scooting around there is DJ. Tackled on the play by number 83. That is Bubba. And I have a hunch these players with these nicknames are the real bad guys of the defense for Kearney Mesa. That's Mean Willie Green, Sam Hollywood High, number 65, and also Marvin Bubba Blanette. Those players look to be one of the strengths of the defense for Kearney. Good look at the stadium there. We have 13-12 again. Third quarter of action, Comets by one. Elkhorn looking to get one before halftime and try to take the lead into the clubhouse. Back over to the side now. And a gain of about 5 yards. Defense all over that play by the Comets. They need to hold them here to try to preserve that lead, as Kearney wants to go in with that one-point advantage and retain it. As they get it up to around the 46-yard line. Up the middle, and a first down and more by DJ Anderson. So Anderson keeping things alive for the Braves, and they'll have more time to use to try to get one in. And a big play it was, that ball going to about the 35-yard line as they're in now Kearney territory. Flip pass. And now shovel back out to the running back. Nice play. Good combination to the players as they were able to move one up. Another 5 or 6 yards on the play of gain. And Bubba, number 83, on the stop as Anderson with the football. And now we're going to have a timeout with 2:04 remaining in the first half. 13-12, Kearney Mesa. So time back in. Coach really not happy with where the Braves are. He wants to try to get them to try to put one more in there and try to. I guess he feels he has enough time for that to happen. Referees will call their own timeout here as they try to get themselves in their proper spots, get things going again. Kearney really has. Like I said, it had a tough year. They did play great against Mira Mesa, though. The only exception of the, I had said the highest point total was 13 points. That was incorrect. It was 44 against Mira Mesa. Discounting that one, that's their only win of the year. They won 44-0, so they really had a good day against them. Running towards the right now, faking and passing. And right there, a nice catch by the Braves, and he is right near the goal line. Eric Patton. Over to his favorite receiver, it looks like today, Jordan Beal. And Jordan has caught about 3 passes already in the first half, and he's had a great day. It's almost like an alley-oop pass where who could come down with the first, and Jordan has got the long arms and the height. And now the Braves will call another timeout, and I believe that's their last one that they can use before for this half of play. As they trail again, 13-12. Braves on the verge of coming into the halftime clubhouse with the lead at halftime. We'll be right back right after this. Play from scrimmage as we begin the tail end of the first half. And he's short of the goal line. Anderson, next play from scrimmage. Here it comes. Frankie Clark, and that one, again, the Kearney doing a good job on nice tackling. I believe that was, if I'm not mistaken, I think that was Ricky Barker on the play there. They listed on offense as a guard, but I think he played defense in this game too, and we'll be right back again. So they keep calling timeouts, trying to hold things down, as the Kearney, I think this time, took the timeout to try to figure out how to stop the Braves and figure out what they were trying to do offensively. They've been doing a lot of running plays, and that you never know, he could do a bootleg right now. And he'll run up the middle, and he is in the end zone as Frank Clark scoring on a 2-yard touchdown run for the Braves, and they're back in the lead again for the second time, leading it 18-13. So El Cajon persevering, they lost the lead, but they've got it back. Kearney now will go to the clubhouse trailing, but they know that they can do something offensively. They proved it twice today, and I'm sure they'll have more of their moments of glory throughout the rest of this game. 1-point conversion, no good. They couldn't get it past the 3-yard line, and that should be close to the end. No, we got a minute 24 to go, so we got some time left over. Anybody wanting to contact me today, well, hey, not a good day to do it. Football is here, and I'm going to be involved with it all day this Saturday. It's been really a great afternoon of football and morning. And now the Braves have the football as they recover a bobble return. And now they have a chance to finally wrap this halftime up and come out with a lead for sure. As Kearney was hoping to get the football and put one in the end zone right away, but they couldn't handle the return. And a big play by the Braves. So go now, see if they'll rest on the laurels and be conservative, or what? I guess they will, as they pass it out, over, hand off, pitch out to Anderson, that is. Anderson wrapped up for a moment, and now a cluster of comments all over him, led by number 55, Raul Marquez. So I guess the Braves will be happy with this lead, and why not? They were behind in the game more than one occasion, and they've come out to lead once, fall behind again, and then come back in. It's been a seesaw battle, no doubt. 18-13 Braves, under a minute remaining in the first half. Patton. Back to throw, and he's got a man open. Nice pass, too. Over to Clark. He's untouched now. He gets away from the tacklers. No one behind him as he scampers into the end zone. The Braves have scored another touchdown and a big play. They don't have much time left in the half, and they're able to add to that lead already. And now it's 24-13 El Cajon. And the home crowd is loving this as they have built up now an 11-point lead midway through this football game. And now we have an injury on the play. I think it was against the Kearney team, as we're off a stoppage and play for a moment as the Braves will try to kick the extra point. So this team really hungry for this win, because they know they'll be in the playoffs after it. And they know they have to do it today. If they lose, I think the chances of them being in the playoffs are not as good. Well, of course they wouldn't be as good, but I don't know if it would be a tough thing for them to get into that spot. And now a shout of the cheerleaders for the Braves, cheering on their football players. We got 19 seconds to go, 24-13 the score. And a shout of the fans, very happy today, and rightfully so. The Braves scoring two touchdowns in the last 5 minutes of the first half to take the lead back and try to hang on to it. A lot of moms out there watching their kids grow and become men at an early age playing the game of football. And now going off the field is one of the Comets as he was shaken up. He's walking with a help. It seems like I'll be okay. Extra point conversion, and that one is good. And the Braves now lead it 25-13 as we're closing in on the first half. Bunch of happy Braves there on the sideline. Take a look at Toby Grider, number 80, and then a quarterback again. Eric, Braves with a commanding 12-point lead. Lifted up towards the side. Kearney hoping to get that break. It was touched out before it went out of bounds, I believe. Indeed. Oh, no, apparently not. Apparently they had, I thought they had touched it. Apparently he watched it, and his foot was out of bounds when he had touched it, maybe. So, let's see who the referees are going to call in this play. He's going to call a flag, and I thought that was because the ball went out of bounds, and the kickoff was just no good, but they're, I guess, going to start there. guess that was not a flag after all. So I thought he did touch it in bounds, and I guess that is what has happened. And so Kearney will get the ball and see if they can get something going. They don't have a lot of time, though, to do anything. This half just about over. Kearney led by quarterback Jason Valletta and Ali Ross, as well as Chris Williams, number 32, and now a flag's flying in the air. See if this will be an offsides call. And it goes against Kearney, so something they didn't want to see, but have to live with it. There is a look at number 52 for the offensive Kearney, the center, Mike High, with the very important job of delivering his snaps to number 12, Jason Valletta. Very important for the center and the quarterback to know each other, know their tendencies. Sometimes if you change quarterbacks and the center hasn't played with you a lot, sometimes his style isn't quite what you're used to, and he can end up fumbling a snap, and all of a sudden the tide will turn. So big part of a team, of course, the center and the quarterback communicating. Kearney handing it off. I guess they're content to talk things over at halftime and see if they can sort out what had happened at the end. El Cajon with a rush of touchdowns at the end of this half, taking the lead, and now a timeout's going to be called by the Comets. Just seconds remaining in the first half. I'm George Langevin. I hope you're enjoying this videotape, and I hope we'll be seeing you out there for many seasons to come with different events. Do all different kinds of sports in the San Diego County area. Braves with a 25-13 lead. The Comets will see what they're going to try as they wrap this halftime up. This actually second quarter up. Flipped over, and nice catch there by Todd Parker, the tight end. Todd's second catch of the day. I know he had a couple near him that he couldn't catch. And that's the last play of the first half, the end of the first half with the score. El Cajon Braves 25, and the Kearney Mesa Comets 13. We'll be back with the second half in just a moment. Second half of play just about to begin, the third quarter of action. Braves leading at 25-13. I do want to mention, during the halftime show, you enjoyed watching the El Cajon cheerleaders. We had Erica Abbey, Karis Beal, Jennifer Branton, Tracy Branton, Jocelyn Christ, Brooke Hunthammer, and recovered now by Kearney Mesa as they get the ball at about the 42-yard line. Kathleen James, Kelly Martin, Janelle Maxwell, Jamie Nye, Ashley Pelfrey, Amber Thatcher, Desiree Thompson, Belinda Tidwell, and then finally we had Joanne Trojano, the cheerleaders at halftime, and I hope you enjoyed that, and also the look at the El Cajon squad trying to get fired up and trying to really get going even more so than they have already. They had a good first half, four touchdowns by them, two by Kearney. And the Braves are on a roll. First and 10 for Kearney, and a fumble, and the Braves recover the football. Nice hit by the Braves. Nose tackle, number 38, Max Maxwell. Great play by Max, and the Braves now get the football back. The Braves now have an opportunity to extend their lead, leading already by 12. And the beneficiary of that hit by Max, you see Justin Phelan being congratulated by all the coaches. Major play in that as he recovered the fumble. Over there now is Anderson. Anderson having a field day at running back, right out to about the 25-yard line. Tackled on the play by number 11, that's Ike Okenwa. 8:56 remaining, we're just underway here. 25-13 is the score. We have an injury, and now we're back in play again. Braves not content with a 12-point lead. They want to just run up as many points as they can. And here comes Clark. Clark running hard, but he's getting tackled by number 83, Marvin Bubba Lynette. Marvin's had a very good game. He's had a lot of tackles today. One of the leaders of this defensive squad. We, of course, mentioned Sam and also Mean Willie Green. That threesome has had a good season. At least in the latter stages, they've been doing a lot better. And of course, in this kind of age, you can improve dramatically over the course of four games or so. Oh, it makes a big difference. Experience means an awful lot at this age. These kids learning how to play football, learning the fundamentals, and a little more advanced, of course, than Marty might. Doing a few more things, more passing. Going towards the outside was Anderson, but he's tackled quickly by number 45. That's Kevin McCaffrey, the cornerback by Kearney. He gets across the 20-yard line to around the 15, and El Cajon bidding for another score. Comets took an early 6-0 lead in the, 7-0 lead in the first half. You take a look at number 42, that being Jake Wastedt, on a 25-yard run by Allie Ross, and then El Cajon answered back by two touchdowns by Anderson to lead it 12-7. Now going, darting around the quarterback, trying to get by some defenders, and a swarm of them getting him there, but he gets a good 5 yards on the carry. Nice play as the Braves trying to get one through once more, but the defense able to clog it up in time. A host of Comets in on the play in that one. Clock continuing to run here in this third quarter. So after one quarter, El Cajon had led 12-7, and then Kearney came back with a 45-yard touchdown run or thereabouts by Allie Ross to take the lead back 13-12. And now this one going through, the Braves trying to get the lead. Run up the middle. Braves by 12 still here in the third quarter. And now the next play from scrimmage, and that one is just short of the goal line as the Comets making a good goal line stand on that sequence. And now a flag is on the play. The referees are going to be marking this one off against the El Cajon Braves. Let's see what the call is going to be on this. Referee's conferring, it's definitely going to go against El Cajon, just a matter of whether they want to refuse it or not. I don't think they will. Offsides, a 5-yard penalty, actually a legal procedure against the El Cajon Braves. Here at El Cajon Valley High School for this football game, the Braves up by 12 points, and the last two touchdowns scored by Frank Clark. Frank scoring a 2-yard run in the second quarter after Kearney Mesa came back to take the lead, and they've never trailed since then. And this one now going off to the side, an onside kick resulting in El Cajon recovering a fumble, resulting in another touchdown to extend their lead and make it, as it is now, 25-13. And that was a big play in the game so far. Again, it could be a lot tighter, being only 18-13. And they also were able to convert that last touchdown into an extra point. They're the only one today so far they were able to muster. Quarterback, Patton, and hand it off. And now they say, yes, it goes in the end zone. Touchdown for El Cajon. And El Cajon now leading it 31-13. Have a commanding lead. Looked like a 3-yard run. Couldn't quite see very clearly who had scored that touchdown. But nevertheless, I'm sure it was either Frank or DJ doing that, or maybe even Bobby. Those two running backs been quite very involved with the offense. Holding will be Frank Clark for number 25. Lee Pelfrey to kick. So they do kick in this league. They just do it mainly when they have a little room as far as taking the chances, because as you noticed earlier in the game, is one of the runners now thinking it's a free ball and he can go for a touchdown, not realizing the ball is dead on an extra point try. He can't score on an extra point miss or fumble or what have you. Well, Braves are up 31-13. And we'll be right back. So Kearney will receive the football as El Cajon will kick it off. So they do try extra points here, but I guess the player skills, you know, at this age level aren't really solidified, and they want to make sure that they got a chance to do it when the score is safe away from making a difference between 1 point or no points and a loss, like, of course, in a tight situation. And I try to rephrase my thought here, because I got a little jumble up there. Basically, in a 16-13 game, for example, and if a field goal try, they wouldn't try to do that. They want to bring these kids along slowly. They want to work them into where they have the confidence to kick the ball from the uprights. I'm sure by Pee Wee they'll probably be doing that regularly. And now a penalty is going to be called. And it's going to go against the Kearney Comets. On the carry for the return was Chris Williams for Kearney, as they'll take it over. Back about 15 yards on a clipping penalty. So first down and 10, back at about the 15-yard line for the Kearney Mesa Comets. Back to throw. Kearney, and he can't hold the football. That was intended for Baker. Thrown near his grasp, but he just wasn't able to get his hands on it in time, and it's an incomplete pass. So Kearney will go try one more time. We got a second down and 10 coming up for him. See if they'll try a running play. They really don't have a lot of time to do that. They are trailing by 18 points now. They've got to score 3 touchdowns to go ahead, and that, of course, contingent on if they can get their extra points. Well, they've been doing pretty well with that so far. 1-for-2 in conversions. El Cajon is 1-for-4 today. And extra point tries. Back to throw once more. Flipped out over. This time he gets his man open. The catalyst, Allie Ross. Allie with some blazing speed. He's faster than anybody I've seen on the field so far today. Exception of maybe some of the cornerbacks, as he crosses the 50-yard line. Stopped on the play, I believe, by number 64, Chris Chaplin, the free safety. Good run by Allie Ross. Allie's had a very good game so far. He really has just great speed. I wonder if any cornerbacks are as fast as him, as they get about 5 yards on that play. Allie on the carry once more. So now the Braves settling into the defense and see if they can get themselves going, as Kearney now coming out for their next play. I believe that was a first down carry by Ross, who has done most of the offensive damage for Kearney today. Valletta in trouble, and he is sacked behind the line of scrimmage by Brian Lloyd, the free safety. So I don't know. I think El Cajon maybe had a safety blitz on. They know that Kearney's got to throw the football now. They've got to try to save time on the clock. And, of course, when you're behind, that's going to happen. That's the danger of the ball resting right on the 45-yard line. A couple of shots of a couple of the Brave players on the sideline there. You have number 85 and El Cajon, Tyler Crane, and also number 32. Over there, Aaron Saunders, the offensive tackle. Flipped out, over to Williams. Got some blockers in front, and he gets pushed out of bounds. And let's see where that ball is going to be spotted. Can't really quite see too well from here. And I believe it's around the 35-yard line or so. Actually, no, that's around the 40, like, 3-yard line. O'Kearney trying to make a drive out of it, and they're looking successful in doing so at this point in the third quarter. Here comes Ross. Good moves by Hayes. Looks like a good, talented runner. He really is. He gets a first down and more across the 35-yard line. Allie Ross with close to at least 100 yards or more today on the ground. He's looked sharp as he scored that first touchdown from the line of scrimmage and later had a good 40-yard run or so. I bet he's close to at least 150 yards on the ground so far today. Again, Pop Warner, most like a minor league system for the major league sports of high school football, collegiate football. You know, as you keep on playing, you get the experience in the background and understanding of playing. And here comes Kearney again. You know, Chris Williams, another 5 yards on the play. Tackled by Lee Pelfrey. Lee, of course, also the kicker for the Braves. They try it again. It worked last time. They'll do it once more. Williams once more along the left-hand side. Going by, good blocking, and he's in the end zone for the touchdown. So Williams scoring the TD for Kearney. About a 15-yard touchdown run. Well, you go to the well as much as you can if no one's going to stop you, and that's what Kearney did, and it paid off for the touchdown. And now it's 31-19, El Cajon leading in the football game. And now a broken play for the extra point, and let's see. No good is the call. They couldn't get it off. And a good reaction by their number 72, all excited. Travis House, the defensive tackle, running in with his arms extended. The Braves feeling good about things so far, and they had a lot of confidence going in the game. Felt as though they could easily beat the Kearney team, but I tell you, it hasn't been easy by any means. They are leading by 12, but they were not leading in the game for good, at least up to this point, until the second quarter. Kearney actually took the opening possession for a touchdown in a hurry. So the Braves now will receive this kick by Kearney. Let's take a look at the kicker for the Comets. So get ready to get started. I couldn't quite identify him. Wanted to try to see who that was. This one going over and around the 45-yard line, and then a tackle there by number 87 for Kearney. If I'm not mistaken, I'm trying to find him, and I think that maybe that was Ricky Barker, number 67. Six could have looked like an eight, and I think he's the one who made the tackle on that. Trying to be as accurate as I can, folks. If I'm making any mistakes, I do apologize. My goal and any person in media is to try to be as accurate and fair as you can in sports reporting or in media news reporting. And now this one's going to be going against Kearney. And I think that's an offsides call. So it'll be a first and 15 for the Comets. Actually, for the Braves, that is. Actually, first and 5. I'm looking the wrong way here. El Cajon moving to our left in the quarter. And here comes the quarterback. Nice run all by himself, and he gets over to the 35-yard line. Good run by Eric Patton. He got a good 15, 20 yards on that carry. He went from the middle of the field towards his left and showed some speed, too. Taken down by Brian Lovell, number 56, the linebacker. So now another penalty. This one will go against El Cajon, and they're not too pleased about it. As they get set down the 15 yards. Well, the Braves with a lead of 12 points. Trying to get a chance to find out what time's left in this period of play, quarter of play. Hand it off. And a nice run by Frankie, tackled immediately by after he got near him by Tommy Gregson, Kevin McCaffrey, the cornerback, number 45, as he gets over to around the 45-yard line. And now nailed right away, DJ Anderson. And the end of the third quarter, as the final play has been made, as Kearney making a good one to end that quarter of play, as the Braves leading at 31-19. So here we go, fourth quarter of action. El Cajon will be attacking to our right once more, like they did earlier in the game. Pass almost intercepted. Oh, nearly intercepted by number 56. That is Brian Lovell. He had it in his hands, but he just couldn't hold on to it. I think it surprised him so that he just wasn't ready for it. But he made a good defensive play in stopping that one, so an incomplete pass for the Braves. And I think this is going to be close to a fourth down. No, it's a third down play coming up here. So the Braves looking pretty good today, showing some offense. Running has looked very good. Nice cut tackle. And that was number, I believe that was Hollywood doing the play on that one, making a good stop on that action. So the Braves will make some switches as they call the plays from the sideline. See if they can add to that 12-point lead now in the fourth quarter of action. O'Cone and Kearney each exchanging a score in the third quarter. Running out towards the left side now is quarterback Patton. Untouched so far, and now he gets stopped by number 65, Hollywood, making the tackle. And that will stop the drive of El Cajon as Kearney takes over first and 10 here. Running for it is Ross, and Ross getting mileage out of his speed, and he does it once more, crossing the 40 over to close to the 45-yard line. Allie Ross, really a great running back, and I really hoping to see him playing for years to come. He's got tremendous quickness, moves, speed, and really once you get him out in the open field, forget it. And we saw that a couple times today. He's already scored two of the touchdowns for Kearney Mesa today. The last one being scored by Chris Williams. So we'll see what Kearney can do. They're trailing it by 12, but they do need more than one touchdown to get back into this game. Handing off to Williams. Ross in front to try to help block. Tackled by number 26 of El Cajon. And I'm looking to see where his number is in my program. I don't believe I have it, unfortunately. Sorry to say. Sometimes players will change jerseys all of a sudden. They'll want another number. And things at the last minute happen, and then you don't have the information. And I think we're going to have an injury on the field here. Yes, indeed, for one of the Braves is down. 7:59 to go. El Cajon on top by 12. And there is number 44 walking on his own. He's doing okay. That's Mike Martin, the outside linebacker. He's shaking up on the play, but the coach will bring him in and give him a rest. Apparently, he'll be all right, and I'm sure he'll come back into the game afterwards. Kearney bidding to inch forward a little closer now. Ball on about the 20-yard line as they're in El Cajon territory. Ross weaving to the outside, trying to cut around him. Good moves again by Ross. Really a good running back. Tackled by a twosome of players for El Cajon. We have Brian Lloyd as well as Gabe Swan in on the stop. To 19, Braves by 12. Kearney, did they draw them offside though? I don't see any flags, apparently not. Gain of a yard or two if they can. So a third down play coming up here for the Kearney team. They want to get a score, it's very important. Ross going to the outside, very slippery. He's almost like grease on some of these players. They just can't get a hold of them. He gets across the 10-yard line, and let's see, is that enough for the first down? And we're looking at the yardsman from a distance to see if they will call it a first down. I think they will. It's going to be close. Let's see if they're going to have a measurement. And now we're going to have a timeout for a moment here. And coach is looking on, hoping that El Cajon can stop Kearney's drive here and ice the game. Even though we are in the fourth quarter, we got a good 8 minutes or so to go. A two-touchdown lead, with the offense getting the ball, who's in the lead, it looks pretty tough to overcome. And now I think Kearney drew El Cajon offside. That may result in a first down for sure, if it isn't already. And let's see what the referees are going to do. We were talking a little more about Kearney. After they played Mira Mesa in week six, they ended up going to Grossmont in week seven, losing 34 to nothing. Grossmont have been a traditionally strong team with Edward Young III and company. Then they played this week, and they really looked pretty good. They've really done very well. They've scored 19 points and are right in the game. And of course, if they score one more, they'll be only 6 points away from tying it. So I'm sure this team has really come a long way since the start of the year when they lost to Los Toros and IB in South Bay and only scored 13 points in three games. So this team looks like a really improved team from that team of the first 3 weeks. Going out to the right, left-hand side, sweeping out. Trying to get in, he does. A touchdown for Kearney. Kearney gets the score when they need it. Chris Williams. That's 31-25, and Kearney looking to try to get the ball back and to tie it. And now they'll try to see if they can get the extra point. So a second touchdown run by number 32, Aaron Saunders. Chris Williams, looking at the wrong sheet here. Chris Williams for the offense of Kearney Mesa. Of course, Aaron for El Cajon is the offensive tackle. Does not do any running, just a lot of blocking for the El Cajon squad. Here we go now as we try to get the extra point. Williams trying to get in, and no good is the call, so he does not get in as he is tackled by a host of El Cajon players, including number 76, Gabe Swan. So we're in the fourth quarter with El Cajon leading it with 5:33 to go, 31-25. Kearney will kick it off. Number 83 will do the honors. Pretty good kick. Skipped away from Elkhorn, passed around the 40-yard line, and recovered by the Braves there. So take their downs in that series. Kicking for the Kearney Mesa team today was Marvin Bubba Lynette. So he does the kicking honors for that team. Running for about 3 yards or so with the Braves. And the Braves now are going to just try to eat the clock up. They've got a 6-point lead. Of course, they want to get the insurance touchdown to try to take control of this game for good. Coming out of the game there, you take a look now at number 45 for El Cajon. That's Tommy Allison, the tight end, as well as number 35, Bobby Osley.
And I'm sure this video will be a great memory for you and your family for many years to come. And I hope we'll be working with you again next season and maybe even during the baseball year. Here we go now, the next play from scrimmage for the Braves as they get things going.
Now going over towards the near side, towards the, to the left is Clark. He gets a good 5 yards again, and I think that's enough for a first down for El Cajon. And Kearney really has got to get the ball back pretty quickly here. They have a chance at trying to tie this football game up. Kearney with 2 touchdowns by Chris Williams and 1 by Allie Ross. Actually, 2 by Allie Ross for their scores today. El Cajon getting another 3 yards or so from Anderson as they just eat up more time on the clock. Continue to do so. And now we have an injured player on the field. We've had a few of those today. Kearney this time will, and with 3:48 to go in the football game, El Cajon leading it by 6. Once more, it goes over to Anderson. Now, this time, the defender is maybe looking a little tired as he's able to break free. Chasing him down was Isaiah Schisler. And he makes the tackle on DJ Anderson. So the Braves looking to break this game open with a touchdown. A nice gain. There are 3 defenders around him, but DJ plowed through those players and was able to take command of the football. And so we get a shot of the sideline, and the players in a very good mood, and rightfully so. They're ahead by 6, but one more thing. They've definitely got to get something in here. They come this far, but Kearney really has a test put to them as well. They've got to defend them here and get the ball back. And if they do so, they're going to have a long way to get to the tying touchdown. Running around the middle, that is Clark. He is stopped by Kearney. Here look at some of the players for Kearney Mesa there, number 88. And I don't have him on my program, I'm sorry to say. So the Braves once more will try to bid for another score, going to the outside and no one there to get him. And a touchdown for El Cajon Braves. And now they lead it 38-25. And things are looking pretty good for El Cajon this Saturday, October 27th, 1990, as the Junior Pee Wee Braves off now again to a 13-point lead. And the 3rd touchdown of the game by DJ Anderson. And right now, I would almost consider him the offensive player of the game. Now, fumbled snap. And here comes the Braves, and they get it in. Actually, I was a little bit mistaken. It was 37-25. Now it's 38-25 as El Cajon gets their 38th point of the day and are in the lead by 13. So the Braves will kick off now. We'll see if we can find out how much time is left in this final quarter of play. Comets will start their action at around the 32-yard line. And now see if Elkin Home can stiffen on defense and hold them down. And I think that Ali Ross is now going to be quarterback. It looks like he was in that position. And now I think the Comets are going to take timeout. And things will stop here for a moment. With the score, Elkhorn 38 and Kearney 25 with 1:51 to go in the game. So I guess Pop Warner Football's version of the two-minute warning there. Timeout out of the field, and now a quarterback, Jason Valletta. Jason running free on his own, but now getting stopped after a gain of about 10 yards. Enough for, I think, a first down, or at least close to the marker. And now here we go. A reverse over to Williams. He scored twice today. Looking for him for the third touchdown. He lost his footing. He got momentarily knocked away and slowed down nicely by Lee Pelfrey, number 25. He didn't actually tackle him, but he did slow his momentum down for the other Braves who were able to get to him. So he made an important swipe at him. So Kearney hoping that Williams will come through for them and maybe get that third touchdown with a nice fast run, just like Allie Ross did a few times today. And now they're going to talk it over again. You've got less than a minute and a half to go in the game. El Cajon leading at 38 to 25. We'll be right back right after this. Now it's a minute and six to go in the game. Braves on top. And now Kearney is going to try the shotgun play, a long Hail Mary pass, and a caught. Caught, nice play, and good reception by the Kearney team. Oh, a big play, and they got to it. And the timeout paid off as Todd Parker caught a pass from Jason Valletta. But hold on a minute, we have a flag on the play and see what the call's going to be. And let's see if this one's going to come back. Referee now conferring with Kearney. I think it is against El Cajon. Balled around the 30-yard line. So he made a nice 20-yard pass or so, maybe even more than that. Good play by Kearney, and you can see the potential in the boy's arm, the way he threw that football. And so indeed, a first down for Kearney. His penalty has been declined. And a big play. Let's see if Kearney can get another one in. Actually, that's right. It is a 38 to 25 game. So, really, the game is all but over. But now Ross looking to go to the outside, but he stopped and hesitated for a moment, and now he gets nailed at about the 8-yard line. As Kearney looking for their 31st point of the day. My mind slipped for a second, thinking it was a close game, but no. And now Kearney will call another timeout. And let's see if they want to get one more in, make this game respectable, and end up only losing by a few points. Although, you know, anything's possible in this game of football. They got 46 seconds to play with. Back from the timeout is Kearney Mesa, wanting to get one in before it's all over. Here comes Ross. They're gift wrapping him to the ground, and he is stopped by a bunch of Braves, and Allie not able to do anything. As they do the hurry up offense, Junior Pee Wee style, and try to get things going. I'm sure we're under 30 seconds now in the game. Here comes Ross again, trying to go to the outside, but no one in front to help him block her. And he's unable to get any thrust in his legs That's when he can really be dangerous, and that's the only way he can really stop Ross, and that's what Del Cajon's been doing these last series of downs in this football game. And they're going to come out and win this football game as the game is over. The Braves have defeated the Kearney Mesa Comets today, 38-25. Good offensive football game, a lot of fun and entertainment. A lot of fun to watch these two teams playing their hearts out, both of them. Very exciting game, and I hope you'll be rewinding this and watching it over and over. Sure, it's very entertaining and enjoyable to see. So El Cajon behind two touchdown runs by DJ Anderson and a couple by Clark. Beat Kearney today. Kearney with a few touchdowns of their own, two by Ross and two by Williams. Made it a close game, but not close enough, as El Cajon holds on, stays in front, and is able to defeat the Kearney Mesa team today, 38-25. I'm George Landrum, and I hope you've enjoyed it. Well, stay tuned. We're going to be interviewing some of these victorious Braves after the traditional shake of hands, and looking forward to that. And don't touch that stop button. Stay with us.
Show, we have number 22 in your name.
Cody Fox.
Cody, what a day, huh?
Yeah.
All those points on the board. What'd you do out there? What was your position today?
Tackle and defensive end.
So you played offense and defense today?
No.
Just defense. Yeah. So you guys held them down when you had to. They were driving towards the end there and you guys stopped them. They were trying to get another quick touchdown on you and you pulled through. What grade in school are you in?
Fifth.
And what school?
Flying Hills. Squeeze.
Flying Hills. All right, and you're going to be playing football next year?
Yep.
Well, next year's 90 season's not even over. You still got playoffs, and you guys can go all the way?
Yeah.
All right. Thanks a lot for coming by. Okay, and your name?
I'm next.
Guys, you got to spread out. Give everybody room, okay?
Frank Clark.
Frank what?
Frank Clark.
Frank, good game today.
Thanks.
And you had a touchdown, didn't you?
Yeah.
All right, I think that was like the second or third one of the day for the team, and I think that pulled things through for them. The onside kick was a big play. Tell us about that.
Well, me and my friend Bobby right here were containing the outsides, and he got there just a bit before me before I could get the outside, so.
You got it, and it really made a difference in the game, because if you didn't have that onside kick, that game would have been tied, and who knows what would have happened, right?
Yeah.
So you guys won, and a big win for you, so now you're going to the playoffs, right?
Yeah.
All right, who are you playing?
Either Skyline or South Bay.
Can you beat both teams?
Yeah.
All right, you got to believe it.
No sweat.
All right, no problem. Let's get your name. Your name is?
Toby.
Crabtree. Toby what? Toby, how you doing?
Pretty cool.
All right, did you play offense or defense today?
Offense,
what position?
In.
All right, did you catch a couple passes today?
Yeah,
I made the first completion.
That's right, great play. That's Is that your favorite position in football?
Yeah.
And what grade school are you in?
Sixth.
And where'd he go?
Lexington.
Uh-huh. And I take it you're looking forward to those playoffs, aren't you?
Yeah.
All right. And how many years have you been playing football anyway?
Two.
So it's only your second year?
Yep.
So I'm sure you've been playing a long time, aren't you?
Yep.
Do you have a favorite team in football?
Bengals.
Bengals, huh? Boomer Esiason and company.
Yeah.
All right. Well, congratulations today. We'll get him next time around, too.
Yep.
See ya. Okay, our next man.
Ethan Venegas.
Your name again?
Ethan Venegas.
Ethan, how you doing?
Okay.
All right. And what position did you play? I don't even see your number, so.
Right guard.
Right guard. So you got some good blocks for number 35 there. Hang that up. Put that uniform up again so we can see it on the little.
Not one of my favorites.
All right.
I want to be uniform.
And did you make some of those blocks for those touchdown runs for those backs
today? Yeah, I made the last one.
Great. And that was great. Wasn't it a surprise with that extra point where they couldn't get it off on the kick and then they got it on the run, huh? Who's responsible for that block?
No.
I was.
Great. Well, we'll talk to you in a second.
I know.
Anyway, it was impressive the way you kept going at them, you know? What school do you go to yourself?
Meridian.
And what grade?
Fourth.
Do you have anything in school you like to do besides play football?
No.
Not really. Just watch football, right?
No, I like playing football as well.
Do you have any teams that you watch on TV at all?
What?
Do you have any teams that you watch on television?
49ers.
49ers. Everybody loves. You must be a Montana fan, is that it?
And Jerry Rice.
Jerry Rice, too. He can catch the football.
Number, and Roger Craig.
Number 80, huh?
Roger.
And Roger Craig, too. Well, good luck to you next time you're around you play. I'm sure you're going to win another one. Thanks a lot. Okay. And we have. I guess you're the next one. You're looking right at me. Your name? And what grade school you go? What grade school you in? Uh-huh. And fifth grader?
Fourth
grade. So you're one of the younger guys on the team here. I take it you're going to play next year for the same group.
I might go to the Pee-wees.
You might go to Pee-wees. All right. Well, do you have any hobbies at home besides football that you like to do?
I like football, yep.
Football's your main thing, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Who's your favorite team?
Can't think San Francisco.
Another 49er fan.
Yeah.
I guess we're getting a lot of them, aren't we? Well, I mean, the team's undefeated. You can't beat that. And if you follow play the way they do, it's going to make you guys successful, too, like today. 38 points. That's a lot. Is that the most you've scored this year, or have you just had better days than that?
No, we've got 48.
You did? Who'd you score that against?
Raleigh.
Uh-huh. So you did you shut them out? Or?
Yeah, we shut them out.
Oh, you shut them out. No problem. Well, looks good for the next – is it next week your playoffs start? Or?
Yeah.
All right, well, go get them next week and get another win to your total there. Good luck to you. Your name?
Rocky Seamers.
Roger?
Rocky.
Rocky. Hey, Rocky. How you doing?
Fine.
Great name for an athlete. You know, that's a common one. And I take it you're one of the linemen on the team.
Yeah.
What position?
Right tackle.
Right tackle. And you made some good blocks out there for the backs and some of the receivers catching the passes today? All right, that's your job, and you know, it's amazing but how much a guard or a tackle can do. If you block hard enough, get that guy off balance, and the guy who's behind you is right there, he watches you, bingo, he's right through, and he can get like 10 or 15 yards right away. And what school do you go to?
Madison Elementary.
And what grade?
Fourth.
And how long have you been playing football?
2 years.
2 years, so I take it you're playing next year as well.
Yeah.
Well, what do you say about next week? What's going to happen next week?
We're going to go to the playoffs, and we're going to win.
There you go. All right, well, thanks a lot for stopping over, Rocky. Okay, and your name?
David Anderson, or DJ.
DJ. I'll call you DJ. I like that.
Yeah.
I wanted to be a DJ for a long time. And anyway, you are one of the running backs today.
Yeah.
And you're also – did you get one of the touchdowns today?
I got four.
You're the one who got four. Let's think of 35. You're the star of the game, basically, today for what you did. I mean, obviously, it's a team effort. And I know your teammate there is giving you a pat on the back, and rightly so. And did you also score that extra point at the end of the game when they couldn't kick it?
Oh, no, that was the other back, Frank Clark.
Frank Clark. Well, anyway, congratulations to the whole team anyway. Are you the leading scorer for this team this year?
Yeah.
Oh, you, so I take it you're going to be playing Pee Wee next year? Or?
Yeah, probably.
Uh-huh. So what year in football are you now?
This is my first.
Your first year?
Yes, my first year.
It's amazing how long it took you to decide to play football. How old are you?
10.
Wow. So it's a great way to get started, you know. You keep the habit up and keep, you know, being successful, you know, and then you'll be great. I take it you're going to try to play high school once you get going?
Yeah, probably.
Good deal. All right, well, congratulations today. You had some great blocking, didn't you, by the line? Did they really help you out or what?
Yeah.
You had some good moves, too, but I think they did. You're doing a lot of zigzagging around, and it seemed to pay off for you. So go get them next week, and good luck to you in the playoffs. Thanks.
I'd like us to move way down here.
Hi, how's it going? What's your name?
Daniel.
Daniel what?
Daniel Crabtree.
And Daniel, what number were you today? What'd you hold up your jersey so everybody can see it? Number 89, all right. And were you one of the linemen, or were you one of the receivers today?
I was on defense instead of offense.
Oh, defense. What position?
Defensive end.
Defensive end. So did you get any sacks today?
Yeah.
All right. How many did you get?
Five.
Five sacks. All right. Congratulations. You remind me of one of the big guys I used to play, defensive end Mark Gasson of the Jets. He was great at rushing the quarterback. That's great. Well, this is one of your best games. Have you had better games than this?
This is the best one.
Congratulations, though. That's great. Anytime you even get three sacks in a game, you're having a good day. But five, that's fantastic. I take it you're going to be you're looking forward to the next week, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm sure you can do just as well. You feel right? You can beat the next team you're going to play.
Yep.
All right. What school do you go to?
Anza.
And what grade?
Fourth
grade. So you're a little younger than some of these guys on this team, aren't you?
Yep.
Well, I take it you're playing junior Pee Wee next year? Or are you going to go up to Pee Wee?
Pee Wee.
All right. Well, you have any hobbies at home at all besides the football?
Just football.
Just the football. Okay. Well, good luck to you, and go get them next week.
Yep.
Thanks a lot. And your name?
Eric.
Eric what?
Patton.
Eric, how's it going?
Fine.
Good. And you're the, you were the quarterback now. You were the quarterback, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Number 16. Okay, making sure. You had a pretty good day. You were able to mix the plays up pretty good. You even had a few good passes, too, that caught him off guard.
Touchdown pass.
That's it. A touchdown pass, too. And have you had games like this before, or is this one of your better ones, or how have you been doing this season? You've had better. Well, that's great to hear, because maybe you can save it for next week in the playoffs. I take it you're going to play either South Bay or Valencia Park or somebody like that?
Yeah.
They're usually always up there, and they're usually a tough team. But
we played South Bay in the preseason. They beat us 33-0.
Ooh. Then you must get psyched now. Now you got to believe in yourselves, and every day is a different one. You never know. A fumble or two, and then people get down. Just keep at it. What school do you go to?
Shadow Hills in Alpine.
Uh-huh.
I mean, not Shadow Hills, Boulder Oaks.
Uh-huh. And what grade are you in?
Fifth
grade. And do you have any hobbies besides football?
Collecting baseball cards and Nintendo.
Oh, great. And do you play baseball at all?
Yeah.
In the springtime or at a team? Well, maybe we'll see you then. What position do you play?
Shortstop and pitcher.
All right, which would you prefer out of those two?
Shortstop.
That's a pretty active position. Well, good luck to you next week, and I'm sure you'll be up there and playing a good game.
Okay,
thanks a lot. And your name?
Darren Hamilton.
Hi, Darren.
I play on the center for Eric.
Oh, you're the center?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh, so you guys work together all season long, and you got to communicate well, of course, the two positions, and know your tendencies, and maybe when he's... You know, when his hands are up, it's an easy thing to fumble the ball in that situation, but it sounds like you guys got it down pretty good. Is that right?
Mm-hmm. But when we were down there, we were going for a quarterback sneak, and the reason he fumbled was he had his left hand over his right hand when he was right-handed, so he fumbled the ball.
Oh. Yeah, well, things like that can happen, but that's what experience is all about.
Mm-hmm.
Give yourself another few years, and, you know, you get close to high school, and you're going to be a good football player. Are you going to be playing for one of the high schools, you think, once you get going?
Yeah, I'm going to... play for Granite Hills or El Cajon.
Great. Okay, well, good talking to you, and you'll get up next week. Good luck to you in the playoffs.
Bye.
Bye-bye now. And your name?
Sean.
Sean what?
Flowers.
Hi, Sean. How you doing?
Pretty good.
All right. And what position did you play today?
The wide receiver.
And do you have your jersey, your uniform with you?
Yeah, my dad has it.
Oh, okay. That's all right. I was going to say hold it up and show us what your number was. That's fine. And what grade are you in?
Fifth
grade. And what school do you attend?
Alpine Elementary.
Okay. And... So you can, how far is Alpine from here? Not too far, is it in the area?
About 15 miles.
So you have a little bit of a ways to get here, but that's good. That shows that you really are into it. And are you going to be playing for years to come, you think? You're going to keep on playing?
Yeah.
Great. Well, good luck to you, and I hope you guys win next week as well in the playoffs and go to the Q Bowl. All right, say something home for your parents. Want to say something to Mom and Dad?
Hi.
All right, there you go. Okay, thanks a lot. And your name?
Jordan.
Jordan? Jordan what?
Beal.
Hi, Jordan. Number 88.
Yeah.
And were you one of the ends today, or?
No, I was a wide receiver.
Wide receiver. Okay, wide receiver. And did you get any passes caught to you today?
Yeah, I had two passes thrown to me, and I caught both of them.
Great. Well, how have you been doing this season? Very well?
Yeah, I've done pretty good. I've gotten one touchdown. I don't know how many catches I've caught.
Do you have anybody you've had in your play after? Anybody you follow on television that you idolize in the NFL at all?
Webster
Slatterfield,
the
Cleveland Browns. All right, good man to look at and notice.
Yeah.
And they're having a tough season, you know, but they've been in a lot of the games that they've been losing. Mm-hmm. But you guys as well, I mean, they could have come back, and they almost did, but that onside kick really was a big play, and I think that was the key to your win today.
Yeah.
But I think next week will be harder, but I think you can do it, and I think all of you believe in yourselves after today, too.
Yeah.
All right, well, good luck to you next week, too.
Thanks.
All right, thanks a lot. Your name?
It's Casey Spatz.
Hi, Casey. And where were you at today? Position?
Offensive tackle.
Okay, and what was your number on the?
58.
Okay. I remember I spoke to you earlier before the game started. You really were ready to go today, and it proves it. Now, did you get any good blocks for the backs as they scored those touchdowns? Did you have any hand in the touchdown runs at all?
I don't know.
Well, you were around it, huh? You were around the play. What school do you go to? Not a good one, huh? What grade are you in?
Fifth.
Well, hey, you guys are going to win next week, right? All right, well, go get them next week, guy. Okay. Your name?
Patrick Healy.
Hi, Patrick. How you doing?
Fine.
And where were you at? Offense today?
Yeah.
And What were you?
Offensive left tackle.
Left tackle, okay. Another one, I'm sure a factor in the runs today produced by your teammate, number 34.
Yeah.
You had a really good offensive showing today. They said you've had better days. That's good, because maybe you can have this and be your off day, and then next week will be your strong one against South Bay or Valencia Park. What school do you go to?
Austonia.
And what grade?
Six.
Do you have any activities or hobbies you like to do besides playing sports?
No.
Not really, yeah? Do you have any other sports that you like to do?
Fly football on
Flag?
My off time.
Oh, really? That's fun, too. It's a little different kind. But good luck to you, though, next week against the team, whoever you face, and whoever it is, just keep your chin up, and I think you guys are going to do great. Okay, well, thanks a lot. Okay. And last but not least, your name?
Travis House.
Excuse me, what was it again?
Travis House.
Travis?
House.
Oh. Hi, Travis. How you doing?
Pretty good.
Good. And you were on the line, right? The defensive line? Or?
Yeah, and I was playing the linebacker.
So you were real active in the game. Some good plays on defense. You guys shut them down when you had to. A few spurts that they had, but overall you guys really, you know, clogged up the middle of the field. How many years have you been playing football?
Three. This is my third year.
Third year. Okay. So are you going to be playing junior Pee Wee next year, or are you going to be with Pee Wee?
I'm going to go up with Pee Wee.
Oh, with Pee Wee. Okay. So you'll probably be playing with some of the same guys you have playing with this year.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And what school do you go to?
I go to WD Hall.
And what grade?
Fifth
grade. Okay, well, good luck to you next week against whoever it is that you play. And I hear they're going to be tough teams, and I think you can do it. Do you believe in yourself?
Yeah.
Say hi to your parents back home or something you want to say
hi.
At home.
Hi.
All right.
In a high-powered offensive football game, El Cajon prevails over Kearney Mesa today, 38-25. I am George Langevin. I hope you enjoyed watching this videotape, and I hope we'll be seeing you again real, real soon. Goodbye, everyone.